Hello everyone, welcome to our afternoon game drive. Welcome to Olare Motorogi Conservancy. Welcome to Mahali Mzuri. I am Jackson, my cameraman is Gideon. It's another beautiful day today. We're just having a nice afternoon game drive. We have just kicked off. When you look on my background, I can see a herd of buffaloes. There's a herd of buffaloes on my background. This is a beautiful time. Having a plenty of food. You can see the grass are everywhere now. When they live in a hut, this is a way of protecting themselves, especially against predators like lions. Lions are one of the most dangerous or a killer animal for the buffaloes. So the buffaloes normally come together, and wherever you see them, you can see they have a lot of young ones. This is one of the breeding season for them, so they're breeding very well. This year we had a lot of rain, and when you look around, you can see the grass look very, very plenty. Grass are very long, so it is such a great time for the herbivores, particularly. So definitely we're gonna drive along. I just want to drive a bit closer so that we can have a close look for the buffaloes. Actually, they have a kind of a symbiotic relationship with the buffalo. So the oxpeckers normally pick the ticks from the buffaloes, and at the same time they get a food and they protect the buffaloes from the parasites. So it's a little bit of a mutual relationship with the buffaloes. These are typically grazers. They normally just feed on grass. The buffaloes has got a four-chambered stomach. So most of the time you'll find them during their relaxing time. They just keep chewing their cud. Because they're trying to ruminate what they've already eaten. They normally need a lot of water, so this is one of the animals that will not stay without water. The buffalo need to drink a lot of water. They can take about 20 liters of water, or even more than that. Because remember, they produce a lot of saliva, especially when the grass are too long and very dry. The buffaloes produce a lot of saliva because the saliva normally helps them to digest the hard fiber. Right, I'll just try to drive a little bit again. For what I can see, a big male buffalo straight ahead of us. It is full of mud and covering the mud all over the body. That is another way of cooling down, and also it's another way of suffocating the ticks as well. Bigger in size. The horns look massive as well. dangerous one are the solitary groups. They form some bachelor groups. Remember, within a big group like this, there's some young energetic male that they have been dominating the all of this herd. But the older bulls have been pushed away. Sense of smell. This is one of the right times for them sometimes to go down to the valley. They're trying to find a bit safe place for them to stay overnight. And also in some point, whenever it's quite hot, they want to go down to have a drink. So we're going to drive along and see what we can find them. There is limbing. One is limbing. Sometimes they can hurt themselves, especially whenever they play, when they run along the rocks, outcrops, or maybe they're being chased by lions. They wind up breaking their legs. And they can even make them to be a little bit vulnerable, especially for the predators. Whenever they came across like a weak or a sick one, they get by. The little one look a little bit brownish in color, but as more they grow a bit like 3 or 4 months old, they start getting the real black color. find some animals, particularly the hippopotamus. Also, all over the day they just stay in the water, so they are strictly nocturnal. One of the main reasons that make them to be nocturnal is because of their skin. Their skin are quite it's a little bit a bit of afraid of the sun. You know, it's not very sensitive. It's not very good for the sun. So that's one of the reasons why they normally stay. They like to stay. The hippo can hold the breath for 5 minutes. Hold the breath for 5 minutes and then they push up the nose to breathe. These are the most, this is one of the dangerous animals we have in Africa. They kill many people, but anything else. You can hear their sounds. Trying to find a little bit of an angle where we can capture them. And then when you look across over there, there's a woolly neck stock on the other side of the river. Those are the boats that normally feed on fish. We have some fish on these rivers. We have the lungfish, we have the catfish, and the mudfish as well. So the stock normally stay along this river because it finds this is where they can get. You can see one opening of the mouth. I don't know whether you can capture that. They produce quite strange noises. These are also animals that normally been, one of their main predators is the lion. And normally the lions wait for them to come out of the water, and those are the places they can capture them. So whatever they came across on, outside, out of the river, it must be a big group of lions. It must be a pride of lions, like maybe 20 lions break down a bit. Another great afternoon. So we're just getting to the end of our drive. So once again, pleasure for hosting you. Pleasure, and welcome to Mahali Mzuri. This is Olare Motorogi Conservancy, and see you again. Goodbye.